It's my little brother, Petey Ronstadt, over there. In 2007, Petey came out to Cincinnati, Ohio, and we recorded a demo of this very song that we wrote together years ago. It's one of the, until the most recent album, the only song we wrote together. It's called Walk Around.
Walk around real slow. Take us one step closer. Walk around real slow and take us one step closer. Walk around real slow and take us one step closer. Walk around real slow. Take us one step closer. Thank you. on the street. Shadows chased away. Get up, do it again.
it's been a long.
Well, it's been a
long week. I met up with Liz and Pete. You'll meet Liz in the second set on Monday.
Liz and Pete is my other band.
Yeah. So you get the benefit of two bands.
All right.
For one tonight in the second set, but we started Monday and we've been driving around the East Coast. And we're here, so sometimes singing a bluesy song gets all the cobwebs out of it. So I do be a little surprised there.
It opens.
don't look like a door, but it opens. It opens. It opens. It opens.
Well, I'm going to play a song that I've been playing for too many years now. A song by Merle Travis. And we haven't done it on this trip yet. Oh, maybe we have, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Feel free to sing along if you...
I can't go. soul to the company store, 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 company store, 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 company store, 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 company store, 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 company store.
You see me cold, I'll stand at the side. A lot of men sinning, a lot of men. Thank you.
missing in my head. Wishing they were painted red, and I wish you were
track on a brand new album that is only in CD form at present. It's called The Road. So if you don't use CDs as just coasters or frisbees, or they might work as a kite, you never know. You gotta have a gusty, windy day to have a kite. And makes good artwork. But if you do have some ability to play it, we have an album called The Road, and this is the first track from that. Thank you.
Qué bonita, qué bonita, palomita, lástima. Lástima que este
la quitte si c'est pour c'est ça aussi la corde violence tu enseignerai à ballar la bella palomita la bella paloma tu te vai estar solita palomita yo te quiero
some songs, and was sitting on this bench outside of a lovely motel called the Boston Inn.
Yeah.
And the reason I was sitting on the bench outside is because you don't want to sit inside the room. But I started writing this song about traveling. I called it Like a River. And, you know, it's taken some turns and twists along the years, much like a river does. I thought I'd finished it, and then my wife, when she was my fiance, I was sitting in Albuquerque while she was in grad school, and I didn't have anything to do with myself, so I went and sat at a park, and I wrote and ordered the song, and then some years later, I was sitting with the song, and all of a sudden, another part flew into it, so, you know, just every 7 years or so, I write some more to it. It goes like this. We're going to sing one more from a while back. Mikey lives in Ohio, Cincinnati, Ohio. I live in Tucson, Arizona. Makes it really easy to rehearse. But one of those times we were driving across the country with our band that preceded Ronstadt Brothers, which was called Ronstadt Generations. We traveled around the country and the world a lot with our father, Michael J. Ronstadt.
Yeah.
And, yeah. We'll do some of his songs today, too. But we were headed through Ohio. We'd go through there a lot. I don't think you were living there at the time. I think you were living in Philadelphia, but...
Yeah. Well, I don't know what song or when.
But while we were driving through Ohio, we were kind of running through the Cleveland area, and I kept on seeing this word, Cuyahoga. I just loved the word, Cuyahoga. And then I found out the Cuyahoga's a river. And then I found out the Cuyahoga River used to catch fire, which is...
Then you blamed it on the Ohio River and some Cincinnati upset.
I come from a desert where our rivers don't have water.
Usually it's someone in the wash in the river, like cooking a steak.
Yeah. If you see a fire in the river, it's, you know, it's usually a party. It's not anything to worry about. They're roasting a javelina, I think. But I... My first time to New York, to like Hyde Park, I was standing there looking at the Hudson and just marveling at this body of water. And somebody walked up to me and said, isn't that river beautiful? And I said, I don't know, I can't see it, there's too much water in it. But it's a sign of a desert kid. But I started thinking about a river catching fire. I started thinking, how could we as human beings treat this beautiful world in such a way that our rivers would catch fire? And that concept just kind of broke me. So I did what a songwriter does. I tried to pick up the pieces and put myself back together, and the song came out of it. 10 years after I wrote the song, I was on stage singing the song. And it dawned on me that this wasn't a song about the river, this is a song by the river. So this is a song that the Cuyahoga sung for me. And it's called Will You Fade?
Step earlier. I got to do TEDx Cincinnati, and it was someone had dropped out. It was kind of a cool presentation. I realized it's a great presentation, they don't do good sound in most of the TEDx, and that's for musicians. It's usually good for talking, but what I really liked about it was I was, one of the people was a doctor from Tucson, Arizona, my hometown, so I had a good conversation and reminisced about home, and they said, what kind of cello do you play? I'm like, well, let's just say blues cello. So I wore a cool hat. I thought it was kind of cool. And put on a suit and showed up. So this is another blues-ish song. I always write blues-ish songs because they're not quite 100% blues. oopsie. So anyway, this is called Take My Words, and I like to get. Who needs a distortion pedal when you have a cello?
Return you, and you'll never be the same.
That's Peter Dalton, Ronstadt. We're going to take just a short little breakdown. We'll see you guys in 15 minutes. If you want to find some merchandise, we'll be up there. I have a new band. It's called Liz and Pete. That's Liz.
That's Pete.
We're Liz and Pete. And we just got off, got done with a few day run that Mikey joined us for, and got to play the part of a accompanist, which is fun. So we thought maybe we'd share some Liz and Pete songs with you. And then there's some material that we all share together, so maybe we can do some of those too. This is the newest song that, not that I've written, but the newest song that I've finished, we've finished, and I'm performing. And it started on Christmas Eve. My wife, Jackie, and my daughter, Annabelle, and I were at one of my daughter's friend's house because she's in kindergarten and she has a lot of friends. So we find ourselves at these houses where we don't know the adults there, but your kids are friendly, so you're trying to get to know each other. And I'm awkward in those situations, so I bring my safety blanket. And I was sitting in their living room, playing this guitar, trying to have a conversation through playing the guitar. And a little line popped in my head: "Young bird sailing on the wind, wondering where has my love been." And I was like, I think that's a song. So somebody was telling me about Greece, and I was trying to listen to them and jotting down words and playing and jotting down words. And finally, it all came together on New Year's Eve. We were playing a gig at a ranch, and our gig kind of got blown to the next day because...
hurricane winds and rain.
Yeah. Loss of power, all the fun stuff.
Yeah, it was cold, too.
So, us and a good friend of ours, Don Armstrong, and Jackie and Annabelle were all sitting in this little cabin with a wood-burning stove to stay warm. And
bundle up, yeah.
The power went out, and we're like, oh, we hope there's enough wood because the heat is electric. But it all worked out, and we finished the song. This is called The Ballad of Young Bird. Right?
Right.
Right, okay.
Thank you.
birds sailing on the breeze, all that's left are memories. Young birds sailing far away once more. A young bird sailing on the moon, she sailed far away too soon. She's a melody that fiddles to my soul. 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 To my soul.
Here's one we wrote last September. We had played Cafe Lena, and we were trying to get back to Philly to Cafe Lena in Saratoga Springs, New York, and we were trying to get back to Philly to catch a flight out. And we'd found out Mikey was playing a house concert that night in the Philly area with a gentleman named Craig Dickhart. And we thought, oh, it's a 5-hour drive, we can make the house concert. So we left at, I don't know, 11?
And they didn't show up?
We never showed up.
I
think we got into Philly.
I was worried through half the whole set. I was like, what happened? Where's
yeah.
Petey?
We got into Philly like at 1 a.m.
Yeah.
It got awfully trafficky on our way.
Yeah.
Right.
Just
and here's his brother, like at a gig half of the set, going, is there a car accident? Like, I was freaking out. But, you know, sometimes those worries fuel into good shows. So I remember Craig had a good show.
I heard
had a nice
good
drive.
Show.
He probably yeah. You wrote lyrics.
We wrote a song. Oh, good. You know, they say it's dangerous to play the guitar and drive a car, but
it rhymes.
So I'm okay. That's my 5-year-old logic, anyway. Play a guitar while driving a car.
Yeah.
It rhymes, so it's okay. All right. Well, here's a song called "Running Down a Train" that we wrote on that drive. Running down a train from my yesterday. Looking for that.
that child from so long ago. I'm looking for that child from so long ago. Wondering where, oh, ever did she go? I can't stay, I can't see. Could this dream ever be? I'm wondering, where did she go without me? I can't stay, when you roll so far away. I can't say if this dream will ever take. Cause when you run, I will chase till the end of all my days. But I can't stay in one place, no, not today. I can't stay when you roll so far away. I can't say if this dream will ever take. Cause where you run, I will chase the end of all my days. But I can't stay in one place, no, not today. I can't stay in one place, no, not today. I can't stay in one place, no, not today. Searching for the word to tell you why. I'm searching for the words to tell you why. I can't stay, so say goodbye.
Well, Petey wrote, Petey, someone gave him a banjo years ago, and he just kind of didn't say anything about it from my perspective, and all of a sudden, one day, it was at a gig, and I don't know, I said, what? And it's clawhammer banjo, like, you don't do that overnight, you know, like, so,
it was
apparently, well, apparently he's been staring at a wall, you know. Like Woody Guthrie recording an album, going for months and months, he just staring like, you know, and that's kind of what happened. Like you kind of just sat there, whatever you were doing, just
really,
banjo.
You know, somebody handed me this banjo and they handed it to me and I wrote a song on it like right away. And I was like, okay. I don't know how to play the instrument, so I had to spend 3 years learning to play the instrument in order to play the song, but you know, when I wrote the song, I was struggling to find the melody, and I was playing through it, and my dad just started singing the melody, so I was like, oh, that's a good melody. So I pulled out my iPhone and I recorded the melody, and then he sang a melody for a B section. I recorded that, and I said, Dad, go home. He said, why? I said, I gotta write words. So he went home, and I wrote 17 verses, and he came back the next day. And he said, we're going to have to pare this down a little bit. I said, well, Dad, you know what Bob Dylan always said. He said, what's that? I said, you can't let a good verse go unwritten. And he said, Bob Dylan didn't say that. You said that. And I said, that's right. But that's okay. I lie. Often. This one's called Valley of Our Kin. And I don't have a banjo, so I'm going to play it on the guitar. My daughter calls this song banjo. And oftentimes she goes, Daddy, play banjo. I go, I don't have one. She said, play banjo on guitar. Okay. So here we go. It's for Annabelle. Thank you.
liars true. For the thought of any righteous in the Lord, beat the winds around us, whisper the earth's in vain. Will it not abound us when we say the same? The cold wind blows on through the valley of our kin. It rests on angel wings and brings that devil in. Shine, will rock your soul till the morning come. When Brewster's song will show the places we are from.
Our new album out there, I mean, Mikey's new album out there is called The Road. This song is also called The Road, but is not on that album. Although, there is a song on that album that is inspired by this song. This is a song that was a favorite of my grandfather's, Gilbert Ronstadt. And we have an aunt who used to sing a bit.
And, occasionally.
At some point, she decided to do an album that was inspired by a book that her aunt, our great aunt, had put together called Canciones de mi Padre. And that book, our great aunt Luisa Espinel had put together. She was a dancer and a singer in the 1930s. Not many people know of her because there's no recordings of her. But she was pretty big in her time. And was kind of the first singing and dancing Ronstadt to achieve worldwide fame. And she did a whole thing where she would collect Spanish gypsy and folk music and put together these elaborate concerts with costume and dance. And there's a letter that she had written to her father, our great-grandfather Federico, talking about her accompanist that she had found, this young teenage guitarist who was so good accompanying her that he could keep an audience entertained while she would go off stage and change into a new costume. And his name was Andre Segovia.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, no joke. She put together this collection of music of Mexican folk, Spanish folk songs from Mexico that that her father sang when she was a child, and she called it Canciones de mi Padre, and it was print music. And then when Linda decided to put together an album of Mexican music, she used the same model, but she used songs that our grandfather, Gilbert, used to sing while Linda was a kid. So this is a song that Gilbert sang, this is a song that our dad sang, this is a song that Linda sang, this is a family song. It's called El Camino, which means the road. Thank you.
camino.
Solita voy y vengo, como
were lost, so lost.
J. Ronstadt would sing that so wonderfully, so somewhere online you can hear his voice on that, and we try to live up to it as best we can.
Yeah.
Yeah. We used to do this tune with Ronstadt Generations quite a bit.
This is a song I learned from Mr. Guy Davis, who learned it from Muddy Waters, who learned it from Big Joe Turner. So I believe this is a Big Joe Turner song. I got that wrong once at a show in Charlottesville, Virginia.
Our host was a blues expert.
Our host was a blues historian that taught blues history at the University of Virginia. She gave me a talking to. If I had to guess, I don't think Joe wrote this song. I think this song came out of the fields. But it's called Baby Please Don't Go.
Yeah.
Oh.
Baby, please don't go down to New Orleans.
get so.
Our set list was
imagined.
Left on the train.
Here's a song like that. It's called Coyote.
That sounds good.
Mm-hmm. coyote runs, the songbird's all alone. In the land of the setting sun, coyote runs, the songbird's all alone.
That he didn't think a lot of people liked this one. But a lot of times as musicians, you'll go and try a song out somewhere, and you don't get the response that you think you might get. You're like, yes, new song! And then all of a sudden you're like, no one likes it. And you never... And so, but it did make it into a book of cowboy poetry that Buckshot Dot put together, and I transcribed the melody for that. And so, after my dad passed away, I really took to the song. It's called North Wind. And he wrote it while he was touring from, like, all around North Dakota, South Dakota. Didn't see any moving water in February for about a month. So, he was really feeling that hard life that the winter has, so...
so much for hanging out here with us. That's my big brother, Michael G. Ronstadt, on that show.
On your channel? grand cello.
Grand cello, yeah.
That's Liz Serapagno. My name is Peter Dalton Ronstadt. We are the Ronstadt Brothers, and we appreciate you guys spending a little bit of your time hanging out with us.
Give it up for Liz and Pete. Their album is awesome. It's amazing. It started as an album they were doing together, and it turned into a band. So you know it's a good band when it wasn't planned to be a band. And I thought about another thing of, what is it? What's your rhyme about playing guitar while driving again? Does it say that?
It's not safe to play guitar in the car.
After you play the gig at the bar.
It's very true.
Sure you go. And that's for kids, any kids out there, do not drink and drive.
Yes, mind singing a song with us? Here's a sing-along I've never heard
stage
before. No, some of you have heard this. But some years ago, Woody Guthrie, well after he passed, came out with a book. I guess other people came out with a book that he had written. It was, I believe, called House Made of Earth. And I bought it because I'm a huge Woody Guthrie fan, and I thought, you know, I'd like to get in that guy's head a little bit more. And I bought that book, and I brought it home. And my wife is a better reader than I, so she got to it first. And she got so depressed reading that book that I never picked it up and read it. So it still sits on the bookshelf. But out of my wife's depression, I wrote this song. go figure, it happens to be a Dust Bowl ballad.
What's it called, Pete?
I'm not very creative, so I called it Bowl of Dust. but I'm going to sing you I'm going to teach you a chorus. And then hopefully you guys can sing it with us. It goes like this. Oh, my darling, don't you weep. We'll meet again someplace sweet. Sweeter than this bowl of dust we know. Sweeter than frozen snow. Oh, my darling, don't you weep. Oh, my darling, don't you weep. We'll meet again someplace sweet. We'll meet again someplace sweet. Sweeter than this bowl of dust we know. Sweeter than this bowl of dust we know. Sweeter than frozen snow.
Let's start a church.
Last let us rest. The dawn is coming for our best. I'll see you someplace on down this road. Someplace we can call our own. Oh, my darling, don't you weep. Oh, my darling, don't you weep. We'll meet again on someplace. We'll meet again on someplace. Sweeter than this bowl of dust we know. Sweeter than this bowl of dust we know. Someplace we can call our own. Favorite song, our grandfather's favorite song. The words are volver, volver, which means to return, a tus brazos otra vez, to your arms once again, which is what we hope we can do, is keep coming back to this place, because this is a wonderful place. Thank you for supporting it. Come here often, come here always. Venues like this need your support to survive in this world that we live in.
Thank you to everyone who I know drove a long way. There's some folks who drove 2 hours, 4 hours, came to a few shows. Thank you so much. So it's really an honor that we can play music for you over and over again sometimes.
Those that are here from Tucson, we appreciate that too. My grandfather had a band called, well, it wasn't a band, it was a one-man band, but it was called Gibby Ronstadt and the Star-Spangled Megaphone. He didn't use a mic. He used a megaphone. I don't have a megaphone, but we're going to get rid of the mic. So we're going to come down to the front of the stage and sing this song. Just imagine, you know, it's a late summer's day in Tucson. The sun starts to go down. The temperature stops to drop. It starts to drop pretty rapidly. We're sitting out my grandfather's backyard, underneath a cottonwood tree that's about 68 feet tall, eating carne asada, sipping tequila. And he would find that moment to stand up and feel connected to everybody that was there, and he would sing this song.
Yeah. minhas lutas, oração e alocas o coração. E me muero por volver. E volver, volver, volver a tus braços outra vez. Llegaría hasta donde estés. Yo sé perder, yo sé perder. Quiero volver, volver, volver.
Ligadito. Ronstadt on that show. Wow.
Y volver, volver, volver a tus brazos otra vez. Llegaré hasta donde estés. Yo sé perder, yo sé perder. Quiero volver, volver.
Help in your quest to find tortillas. This is a parody written by my grandfather's best friend. Love. You got it. The key of dawn. It's the saddest song I know, so I'm sorry to leave you on a down note. And I hope you brought your hanky, because you might need it. But then again, you might not be from the desert of Sonora, so it might not mean anything to you, in which case, I'm sorry. But I'm gonna cry. I'm sorry for that, too. I love tortillas, and I love them dearly. You'll never know just how sincerely. I love the corn ones, y también la harina. But when my wife calls out from la cocina, there's no tortillas, there's only bread. There's no tortillas, and I feel so sad. My grief I cannot hide. There's no tortillas for my refried.
Lo siento. no burritos without the corn ones. There would be no fritos. I love to hold them tenderly and fold them. Oh, how I dread to eat with bread. Believe me, no hay tortillas, solo pan. No hay tortillas, son of a gun. My dreams I cannot hide. There's no tortillas for my